Hello, good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good
Today,
morning.
I, Ranjit Pandit, and my friend Rohit Gushal will give a brief presentation on the topic regular expression and DFA. In this presentation, we will be discussing about regular expressions and deterministic finite automata in brief, and we will be briefly talking about DFA minimization with two different algorithms. So, let's get started. First, we will cover about regular expressions and its properties, then finite automata with some examples. Then we will having two problems based on two different algorithms for DFA minimization. And at last, we will be having a look at Q&A for of different level examinations. So let's start with regular expression. As we know, regular expression can be defined in the following manner. First, epsilon, which is a regular expression, which indicates a language having a nothing. That means it is empty string. And psi is a regular expression denoting empty language. And x is a regular expression where l is a set of strings. And the fourth point, we have x is a regular expression denoting the language x, and y is another regular expression denoting the language y. So if we add these two languages, then as a result we will get another regular expression. Now we can perform several operation on regular language, and so some of them are, one is union. So we have two regular languages, that is L and M, and if we apply union operation on them, the resultant will also be a regular language. Same kind is with the intersection process and kink closure. There are different properties with regular expressions, and a set which contain regular expression is called regular set. So as discussed, there is a few properties, and I will be just highlighting each of them. So union of two regular set is regular, intersection of two regular set is regular, complement of a regular set is regular, and the difference of two regular set is also regular. Moreover, reversal of a regular set is regular, and at last, concatenation of two regular set is regular. Proof is also given here, so we will not be discussing proof. Let's move further. Examples of regular expressions. So here we are citing an example of a regular expression for a language which accepts all the strings of a set 0, 1, which starts with 1 and end with 0. So for this kind of problem, for designing a regular expression, we need to have 1 at beginning, because the language is asking about that it starts with 1. So we have to give 1 at the beginning, and as we know, it is just asking to end with 0. So at the end, we must have 0, and in between, we have 0 plus 1 closure. That means we can start with 1, and upon giving input 0 and 1 as many times as we can, it will accept and in a closure, and at last, it will end with 0. So this is an example of regular expression that contains 0 and 1 as many times as you can give, but end with 0. We have another combination where the regular expression is, it will be starting with alphabet A, and it may have any combination of B in between them. For that particular, the regular expression will be A B closure B. Similar another example, that regular expression that may not have consecutive B's, but we can have consecutive A, so that can contain a set of A, ABA, AAB, but not ABBA, because we are here giving 2B, so it is not as per the problem that is asked. So general regular expression term will be A plus AB closure. And several other examples we have. Now my friend Rohit Gushal will be discussing about finite automata from here on. Rohit, please continue.
Yes, so finite automata also part of our discussion. An automata with a finite number of state is called finite automata or finite state machine. The formal definition of a finite automata can be represented by a five tuple format. So where Q is finite set of states, summation or set of symbols called alphabet of automation. Next, delta is a transition functions. Q naught is the initial state from where any input is processed, and this Q0 is the part of Q, that is the finite set of states. And the F is the final state, or the state belongs to Q also. Finite automata can also be classified into two types: deterministic finite automata and non-deterministic finite automata. Here we mainly focus on deterministic finite automata, as our main discussion topic is DFA minimization. So what is deterministic finite automata? In DFA, for each input symbol, one can determine the state to which the machine will move. Hence, it is called deterministic automaton. As it has finite number of states, the machine is called deterministic finite machine or the deterministic automata. The example, let a deterministic finite automata be Q with the states of A, B, C, and the operations which 0 and 1, and the initial state is A and final state is C, and delta is the function we will apply on this. So here is a graphical representation. A is the initial state, and we put 0 on A. So we next on A, when we put operation 1 on A, then we move to B, and when we put 0, we'll back to A, and when we put 0 to B, then we go to the final state C or F. And when in C we put 0, we roll back to B, or when we put A, the final state itself goes to itself. That's it. And next we will move to our DFA minimization problem, or how to solve this. Now, DFA minimization using Mayfield-Nerod theorem. Here is a little algorithm for this purpose, where obviously the input is DFA and output is minimized DFA. In the step 1, we draw the table of for all pairs of state QI and QJ, not necessarily connected directly. So here we see in step 1, we draw the table for all pairs of states A, B, C, D, E, F, and vertically A, B, C, D, E, F. In steps 2, consider every pair QI and QJ in the DFA, where QI belongs to F and QJ not belongs to F, or we can vice versa them and mark them. So here we see that AC has a state of pair, BC has a state of pair, DA has a state of pair, DB has a state of pair, EA has a state of pair, EB has a state of pair, but FA, FB has not a pair. But FC, FD and FE both have pairs. Next step, step 3, we'll try to mark the state pairs, then green color the check mark, transitive. If we input 1 to state A and F, it will go to state C and F respectively. C, F is the combination is already marked, hence we mark the pair AF now. We input 1 to the state B and F, it will now go to the state D and F respectively. So DF pair is already marked, hence we'll mark to the pair BF. And now, after step 3, we got the combination AB, CD, CE and D that are unmarked. We got the combination CD, CE, DE into CDE, the one state, one combined state. Hence, we got the two combination states as AB and CDE. Next, so the final minimized DFA contains three state F, A, B, and C, D, E. So here we have the our diagram, that is A, where we put as input 0. So it will come back to A itself, and when we put input as 1, then we go to the final state or the setup state C, D, E. And in the state of CDE, when we input as 0 or 1, then it loops, and when we put only 1 to the state, it goes to F. And in F state, we have 0 or 1, and when we input to this, it loops to itself. That's it. Now we will discuss on DFA minimization equivalence theorem. Ranjit, please, can you continue with this?
Yeah, sure. So here, if we have two states, that is X and Y in DFA, then we can combine these two states, X and Y, if they are not distinguishable. So two states are distinguishable if there is at least one string such that delta of X and S and delta of Y and S is accepting and another is not accepting. Hence, DFA is minimal if and only if all the other states are distinguishable. So we have the algorithm process here. What we are going to do in the first step, all the states Q are divided into partition, that is final states and non-final states, and are denoted by P0. All the states in a partition are zeroth equivalent, and then we take a counter K and initialize it with 0. Step 2, we increment K by 1 for each partition in PK. Divide the states in PK into two partitions if they are K distinguishable. Two states within this partition, X and Y, are K distinguishable if there is an input S such that delta with X and S and delta Y and S are K minus 1 distinguishable. So after doing these two steps, we'll proceed to the third step, that is when PK is not equal to PK minus 1, that is previous state is not equal to next state, then we will step repeat step 2, otherwise we will go to step 4, which is we will combine the kth equivalent set and make them new states of the reduced DFA. Here we will be considering an example. So we have the DFA with several strings A, B, F, N, E, E being the final state, and we have here the delta. Here basically we are discussing about X and S. So here X is Q and S is this and R is 1, 0 and 1. We are supplying 0 and 1 as a set input. So when we will be when Q is A, then Q delta of Q and 0 is A. Similarly, when Q is A, delta of Q and 1 is C. Similar condition, when Q is B, then delta of Q and 0 is A, and when Q is B, delta of Q and 1 is B, and so and so on. Now let's apply the above theorem to the above DFA. So here we have the state as P0, which is CDE one set, and another is ABF. Similarly, P1, we will continue as long as we do not reach to the final state. So we have P1 as CDE and AB another pair, and F as another. And at last we have P2, that is CDE, AB and F. So here we can see that P1 and P2 are equal. Now there are three states in reduced DFA. The reduced DFA is follows. We have initially Q at A and B. Initially, when the Q is A and B, that means when we provide the input A comma B to the Q, we get the output as A comma B in the performing operation of Q comma 0. Similarly, we get output as CDE, and when Q is CDE, we get output same as CDE in delta set of Q comma 0. And when we are applying Q and 1 to the Q, we get F, and the final state is F when all the states are F. Now, here are some questionnaires. Rohit, can you please continue with this?
Yes. Okay. So, regarding this topic, we have collected some questions that appears on competitive exam like GATE or NET. That, and we have collected some 5 questions on that. So, first question, that is, consider the language L1 is equal to phi and L2 is a set of A. Now, which one of the following represent L1, L2 closure union, L1 closure? And that question appears in GATE 2009. And the explanation is L1, L2 closure union, L1 closure. The result of L1 and L2 closure is phi. Phi indicates an empty language. Concatenation of phi with any other language is phi. It works as zero in multiplication. So L1 closure is equal to phi closure, which is an set of empty string or empty language. Then the union of phi and empty is always empty. So the answer is A. Now, the question number 2. Consider the DFA, which is given in the right side of our PPT. So this question appears in GATE 2011, and the question is, which one of the following are false? And that is given is, complement of L1 is context free, L1 is equal to L of 1 closure 0 plus 0, intersection of 0 plus 1 closure 0, and number 3 is, for the language accepted by A is the minimal of DFA, A accepts all strings over 0 and 1 of the length at least 2. And now we have the explanation. One is true. L of A is regular, its complements would also be regular, as from the properties. And a regular language is also a context-free language. The second is true. And the third point. Third is false. Why false? The DFA can be minimized to 2 states, where the second state is the final state and we reach to the second state after C0. Four is clearly false. Why false? Because A DFA accepts a single 0. So our answer is D, where the D is 3 and 4 only. False. Now we'll move to the next question, question number 3. And question number 3 is, which one of the following language over the alphabet of 0 1 is described by the regular expression 0 plus 1 closure 0 into 0 plus 1 of closure 0 into 0 plus 1 of closure? And this question appears in GATE 2012. And our option is, the set of all string containing the substring 0 0, the set of all string containing at most 2 zeros, the set of all strings containing at least 2 zeros, the set of all string that begins and ends with either 0 or 1. Now the explanation. The regular expression has 2 zeros surrounded by 0 plus 1 closure, which means accepts the string must have at least 2 zeros. So we clearly see the set of all string containing at least 2 zeros, and hence our answer is option C. Next we will move to our question number 4. Let W, any string of length n is 0 1 closure. Let L be the set of all substrings of W. What is the minimum number of states in a non-deterministic finite automata that accepts L? And this question appears in NET 2008. And our option is, A is equal to n minus 1, B n, C n plus 1, D 2 n minus 1. Now our explanation is, we need minimum n plus 1 state to build NFA that accepts all substrings of a binary string. For example, follow, NFA accepts all substrings of 0, 1, 0. And it has 4 states. So our answer is C, n plus 1. Now we'll move to our next question. Question number 5. Ranjit, can you move to question number 5? That's it. Deterministic finite automata DFA or D presents the alphabet A comma B, set of AB is given below. So we see the diagram where PQR are the states and S and T are the final states, or F we can say it. So from the diagram we have to clarify which was the finite state is a valid minimal DFA which accept the same language as D. D means the diagram. So our explanation is option B and C are invalid because they accept B as G, which is not accepted by given DFA, or D is invalid because it accepts BBA, which are not accepted by given DFA. So we can clearly see in the picture of A that P accepts the string BBA. So our answer is A, and that's it. And this question appears in GATE 2013, 2 marks question. That's all, and that's it. Our PPT presentation is over now. Thank you. Thank you, my friend. Ranjit and sir.
Thank you, Ranjit. Thank you, Rohan. Excellent. Make your microphone on off, please. Excellent. Is an excellent presentation, but one thing you have omitted the merger graph model to state minimization. That is another thing you should know. The merger graph is one, merger table you have shown, and another thing, there are some states which are no output. So minimization of states, that is also not in your syllabus, but you should look it at Covey's chapter 15. There are some DFA, minimization of DFA. There are some state which is you can ignore the values. So what is the output? Are you getting my question? Not all DFA.
Yes, sir. Yes.
All DFA, but whatever you have taken, the all are clear cut DFA. Every DFA has state transition and output. That we have minimized by the merger table method, but merger graph is another method that you can do. But I also feel merger table is the best method. And another thing is that some tables, some states, there are some missing values. Those values can also be combined. That is a bit tougher. That is a chapter 15. You please read, because GATE those questions can be there. Okay. And otherwise is excellent. And another chapter is there, memory loss. Whether your DFA has loss of memory or not, that is again the chapter 15. But if you have already gone through, that is a little thing you can add. Your slides are excellent, but one thing, too many information is there. And for regarding the question, can you put one question, one slide is, not to put two question in one slide. That's great. Excellent. Thank you very much. Okay.
So thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay. Let's go.